What's up guys, Sal here. So the iPhone 15 Ultra and the Pro will be the first smartphones to use a 3nm chipset, and it seems they will be extremely powerful. But before that, let's see why Samsung is displeased with the latest development surrounding the iPhone 15 lineup. You see, even though Samsung and Apple are rivals, Samsung makes billions every single year from iPhones. How? Well, by supplying components to make the new iPhones. Specifically, Samsung is one of the leading suppliers of OLED displays for Apple. The display is the costliest component in a phone, so if iPhones do well in sales, it's also good news for Samsung. But it looks like things are about to change. You see, for the past few years, Apple is looking to reduce its reliance on Samsung and started diversifying the outsourcing of displays to other companies such as LG and BOE. But up until the iPhone 14, Samsung was still their biggest supplier. That, however, will change with the iPhone 15 lineup, as Ming-Chi Kuo says BOE's shipments of the iPhone displays for 2023 will increase significantly, possibly surpassing Samsung and LG Display to become the largest supplier of displays for the iPhone no later than 2024, which will surely make a big dent in Samsung's profits. You might wonder why Apple wants BOE as its primary supplier, as Samsung is universally known to make the best displays out there. Well, Apple doesn't want to rely too heavily on Samsung because of the competition. Samsung is their biggest competitor in the smartphone market. Relying on Samsung for components would be viewed as conceding a level of control to its rival, which Apple is unwilling to do. Moving on, the iPhone 15 Ultra and the 15 Pro will use a 3nm chipset, while the regular 15 and 15 Plus will use the same chipset that was used on the 14 Pro last year. Today, we have alleged Geekbench scores of the A17 chip for the Pro and Ultra, which show a pretty significant jump in performance. With a 3019 score in single core, it sees a 20% jump in performance year over year. The multi-core is a little bit higher at a 24% jump with a massive score of 7,860. This is for Geekbench 6. Recently, Geekbench revamped multi-core testing to simulate modern workloads. And somehow, iPhones profited from this while Android phones didn't gain as much. So if you want the Geekbench 5 scores of the A17 chip, then here they are, and we see a similar jump in performance. So how does it compare with the best Android at the moment, the Galaxy S23 Ultra? Well, as you can see, there's a pretty big difference in scores, 5100 versus 7800 in multi-core, which is huge. But like I've said, Androids for some reason didn't benefit from the new Geekbench 6. From the testing, we saw that the S23 Ultra performs on par with the 14 Pro Max in various apps, games, and even in rendering, and in some cases, it's even better. Geekbench 5 said both phones offer similar performance in CPU, which is what the test showed. But Geekbench 6 shows that the 14 Pro Max is much more powerful, which is weird because real-world tests showed different results. In any case, it's just a reminder that we shouldn't rely too much on synthetic benchmarks, since they often do not accurately reflect real-world performance. Of course, with that being said, thumbs up if you liked the video, and I'll see you tomorrow. Peace out.